Hello, I'm Matthew Enderly from DivineDynasty.net and MLEStudios.net. Today I'm going to show you how to convert a old bucket plugin, or one that's just currently not built for the server version that you're trying to use. And this will work for most plugins, unless if there's actually something that's broke, then you actually need to know how to fix it. Which usually, it's pretty simple, it tells you exactly what's broken, and you can kind of just like put stuff together and kind of like guess what's up and figure it out. So one plugin that I'm going to do is Coal Diamonds. Now it says that for my current version, dl.bucket.org, now currently when I'm on this, I'm using the development build right now on my server because we're running the latest plugins and I'm manually doing this to all the plugins to make sure that they all work for it. So in a way I'm contributing, but I'm not forking them on GitHub because I don't really want to maintain that. So what I have here is this, and we can see all the version builds. So I'm using build number 3005. Now this one wasn't rebuilt on that. It was rebuilt a day ago, so it will not work with ones that it released today. So what I will do is I would download it, which I had to re-download it, and download, keep. Okay, now one other program you're going to need is called JD decompiler. So it'll be jd.bnow.ca, and we're going to go down to JD GUI, click on the download tab, and download it for the appropriate operating system you have. I already have it downloaded, and when you open it, it'll look like this. Open up the executable file, it'll come up with a little coffee cup for your Java, and this window. So I'm going to just go ahead and drag Coal Diamonds into it. Now you can see that we can see inside the jar. So what we're going to do is, this is the most important step. Not really. But normally when you start up, these two checkboxes are going to be checked. Now you want to get rid of them because otherwise when we export this, it'll put literally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 all the way down the page and it'll actually screw up the code. And we're going to do save all sources, which was under file. Now just save it as coaldiamonds.zip. And you can close out of this, but I'm going to keep it open because I'm going to be doing a lot more. I'm going to go to downloads. And I have my coal diamond zip right here, and I'm just going to copy that, and we'll open up our workplaces. I'm going to paste that in here and export to Coal Diamonds. I can delete that, delete the meta.inf file, and now we get that. Now most people use Eclipse. I liked Eclipse, and then I got Zend Studio, which I like more because I can do Java, and then if I want to switch to a website, just click PHP at the top, and that's it. I don't need to reopen it or choose a different instance or a workspace. It just automatically switches it, changes all my formatting to what I want. So then once I choose Java, I'm not going to do a tutorial on that, but otherwise you just click that and choose Java. So we're going to do a new Java project, ignore the project name, browse, find where we stored that, Coal Diamonds, okay, automatically fill it out, finish. Now if I open it up, you'll see that there's a little red X there. That's because we gotta right click on Coal Diamonds and do build path, configure build path. Now it'll open up the libraries tab, and what we're doing is adding the craft bucket jar that you're supposed to download, which I forgot to mention, which I got mine from that didn't work. Oh, I just did a Google search, that's why. I went from dlbucket.org, and then you click on the alternate versions, and right here, that's what I did, and I downloaded that one, and saved that in my downloads, and here we go. So, now I got that in there, click OK, and now, theoretically, the X should go away, sometimes it doesn't. And you'll get a little triangle. And that means that this person has a bunch of imports that were never used. Now I could get rid of them just to make it a little bit cleaner and a tiny teensy little bit smaller file size. Or I could just leave it because you never know. We really don't want to change anything until we actually know that it works. So this is all good. I'm going to drag that back in there since it opened up in Notepad Plus. Hit F5 to refresh. Okay, and now we're actually good. We're actually good as soon as we open up the craft bucket. Now we right click on Coal Diamonds, do Export. Choose Java, Jar File. And choose where we want. Coal diamonds. And make sure that this is all checked, which it is. So, finish. And it'll give you a little information about the warnings. That's because it's giving you all this, which is from his imports, which is really messy. Usually you try to clean that up, but you don't have to. So, in reality, we're done. Because our jar file is right here. So now I can put that on my server and run it, and it'll work. So, thanks for watching, and I hope you found this tutorial interesting and incredibly successful. If not, please kick cat.